next we'll have Reverend Diane Baker speak for us.
I'll walk up.
American and an ordained minister. 40 years ago, at this time of year, a party of an ecology task force, I carried my one-year-old son on my backpack as we marched and prayed for water in Southern California. Now, as California bakes in the sun and begins to operate the salinization plants to turn seawater into drinking water, they worry about the radioactive waste flowing from the devastation of the Fukushima nuclear reactor. We naturally connect water with the earth, with life and new beginnings. Centuries ago, Native American Chief Seattle shared this with us. Teach your children with what we have taught our children. The earth is our mother. This we know. The earth does not belong to humans. Humans belong to the earth. This we know. All things are connected, which the blood that unites one family. Whatever befalls the earth befalls the children of the earth. People did not weave the web of life. We are merely one strand of it. Whatever we do to the web, we do to ourselves. One of my professors, Howard Kleinbell, said, the suffering of our raped earth is real. I hear the sound of the earth crying. Under the town of Mayflower, Arkansas, is an Exxon pipeline buried only an average of 2 feet below the ground. 1 year ago today, that pipeline began to spew corrosive and polluting tar sands. Homes and neighborhoods were destroyed as the guns flowed across lawns and down the streets toward ponds and lakes. The air became toxic with such carcinogens, including benzene and toluene. The FAA immediately designated the area above this spill as restricted airspace for safety reasons, but certainly preventing news cameras from getting an aerial view of the disaster. Since then, we have experienced more spills, including one in Galveston. Yet the drumbeat for the Keystone X-Line pipeline continues. Are Americans unconcerned or that forgetful? As we work to change public policy, we must work together. Then the load seems lighter. We cannot do everything. We don't have billions to spend on manipulating elections and legislators. But we can work together and join our lights together to remind our brothers and sisters of our Mother Earth and the water she provides. Water has always been sacred. Since prehistoric times, water was treasured. It has forever been incorporated into spiritual traditions, such as births, baptisms, and burials. As I pour... As I pour the water tonight, I offer this prayer. Creator, forgive our disrespect of your precious gifts. We ask you for some measure of peace for those whose lives are upended by these tragedies. We ask for courage, we ask for wisdom as we search for ways to tend to our only home, the source of life for us and for our children and our children's children. I close with the words of a Kenyan proverb, care for the earth. It was loaned to you by our children.
Amen. Amen.
Thank you, Reverend Diane. That was very, very beautiful.
So, what I'd like to do now, we will have some closing words, but I think that we should take a little bit of time.
Feel free to take it in silence, but also in community, because that's the power and the strength that we have, is our community together. So we can move around and